The earth is filled with finite minerals, but with human intervention, how long will they last? Another century? With the current plunging rates of extraction and consumption, it does not take an expert eye to know that we are heading towards extinction because of our very own choices. As simple as the relationship between the consumer spending and production is, we fail to realize what builds it. Production is not possible without extraction of non-renewable resources. But the demand is increasing and extraction has forgotten its limits. From under 7 billion tons in 1910 to 80 billion tons and counting now, that is an overwhelming 10 zeros, an alarming increase of 11 times the amount within just a century. These increased rates of mining have a lot to do with the consequences. Since these reserves are often forest caves or underwater, deforestation accompanied by its consequences becomes inevitable, endangering millions of animals and marine life. The toxicity even spreads to the water bodies, which are further consumed by many. It is sacrificing not only the environment, food and water that a generation are going to grow up, but the safety of millions of families like ours who are exposed to this threat. Imagine a canvas where all the colors have been taken away and we are left with all grays. That is what the earth is going to be for our future. Our mind is filled with doubt and is realizing the urgency. But if we still think that changing our ways is not going to create a difference, we are wrong. We are the consumers. Our demand asks for these processes to happen. Since a few past decades, we have been spending money not on our needs but on our wants. Look around, things you don't necessarily need. Approximately 6 pounds of trash is thrown out per person each day, a whopping 2,210 pounds in a year. If resources were not wasted and recycled to produce more, extraction would have been out of question. We can't stop the production, but what we can do is practice the 9 R's. Rethink about the future we are creating for our family and its coming generations. Refuse buying products from companies that do not follow the green circular economy model. Reduce buying things that we don't necessarily need. Reuse all materials till they no longer can be. Regift if something is no longer needed. Repair instead of buying new products. Rent things that you temporarily need. Recycle every piece of scrap. After all, waste is just another resource in the wrong hands. Rot your bio-waste. These small steps are the key to help us build a better society. The paradise is waiting.